Super Monkey, Sniper, Village, and Bonnie. This is the current meta strategy in Balloon Seabows 2, and today I'm gonna show you how to use it. Let's hop right into it. And it looks like our first match here is a Bonnie versus Bonnie matchup. And we are on the map of Offtide for the first match as well. So we're gonna start with a 0-0 sniper here because we are going the strategy of Super Monkey, Sniper, and Village in today's video, which I do think is actually a meta loadout right now on a lot of maps. I haven't really learned the strategy too well, but my friend Gaming Two Top did send me some videos of kind of how to play the strategy. So I watched those beforehand and kind of studied them a little bit. So hopefully I'll know what to do here. Gonna start with the shrapnel shot sniper though and get my Bonnie down round one. We will be sending spaced eco towards the opponent on pretty much most of these early game rounds will be the plan. And we're gonna be upgrading the sniper to a 0-2-2 is going to be the best way to do it. They got their tac shooter down in the back, nicely done. Even faster shooting on this. Bonnie's minecarts will start coming out in round three, which will be good for us. They actually don't have Bonnie down on their side yet. Wait, what? It's round two. Is the opponent going to get Bonnie placed? No Bonnie still. Okay, well, that's very good for us then. No Bonnie from the opponent is quite bad. Let's actually move our camera down here. Send them yellows. Okay, they're sending me blues. Now is the point where I actually start building up more snipers. And we're just going to get unupgraded snipers is what I see. My friend doing. He just spammed like three or four unupgraded snipers on strong. And these are actually quite effective. Especially against like white balloons and stuff and pink balloons, which are typically something you have difficulties with this loadout. All right, opponent got Bonnie down. Nicely done. We got three snipers and the 0-2-2. 0-2-2 is unclosed. These snipers are on strong. We're going to upgrade Bonnie's minecarts a little bit. And we'll be upgrading all these snipers to full metal jacket is going to be the plan here. Upgrade Bonnie again. All right. Full metal jacket. We'll get full metal jacket on that one. And we will get full metal jacket on this one as well. Okay. It looks really weird, guys, but I think this is the optimal way to play this strategy early game. You could try saving up for a semi-auto rifle, but that's really expensive. And you'd have to, like, you die before you save up for it. You have to buy defense and sell defense for it. So doing this is more effective. And it looks like we are popping down those white balloons well. Do these catch up with white balloons, or do I need to go for another full metal jacket? I might need a fourth. I'm going to explode minecarts, though. Which should buy me some time. And now we'll get up a fourth full metal jacket. And with four of these, that should pop white balloons entirely. Yeah, this is good. And it's more efficient to get multiple of these than get faster firing on one of them. The faster firing upgrades are not worth it for a low tier sniper like this. So that's something else that should probably be noted. It's still actually falling behind a little bit. Maybe I get shrapnel shot on one of these. Okay, shrapnel shot on a full metal jacket does appear to make a decent difference too. Yeah, this is defending. This is defending. We're good. We're vibing. Okay, yellow balloons are actually going to be annoying. I'll probably have to tower boost these, but that's totally fine. We'll tower boost now. And we'll explode minecarts as well. Alright, that should defend yellows. We've got 220 minecarts now, which is actually pretty good for us. His opponent's still sending yellows after that. They are. Okay, we're going to get another sniper in our back in the back then. On close targeting. And we're going to get another one of these on close. This should defend yellows. Maybe another one close. Okay, yellow balloons are actually pretty scary, I'm not going to lie. But we're good. We're good. We're good. Just buy shrapnel on everything. Just get shrapnel on everything and we're going to get yellows. All right. And now the plan is we're going to get a discount village here. This is something I didn't do last time I used the strategy, and it's actually really important. Discount village, monkey commerce, and we can get a bouncing bullet under discount, which is really good. Now, our early game obviously wasn't perfect. This is the first time I'm trying this new early game route, but it still was good. I mean, the especially defending yellow balloons. Yellow balloons are one of the hardest things to defend with sniper only start, so it wasn't awful. I should be able to forward this bouncing bullet pretty easily here. If the opponent doesn't rush me yet, I am going to get a monkey economy first. Opponent also needs camo detection on their side. Okay, they got village. Fair enough. Monkey economy first. Now we'll get bouncing bullet on this. Nice. Unfortunately, I did leak a ton. I just realized that. If I got those sniper upgrades earlier, I probably still would have the life advantage on the opponent. But I'm not really too worried about the life advantage because I still think I can kill them late game with our loadout. We have such good money generation with sniper farms and Bonnie eco that even though they have life advantage, and if their third tower is like glue gunner, I'm guessing, I still think we'll be good. Okay, now the plan is we get the supply drop super early. That's great. And once we got the supply drop up, I'm going to upgrade this large caliber as well. And this should work out pretty well. We're in a very good spot. Very, very good spot here. Gonna up. Now that we got supply drop down, we're gonna upgrade Bonnie a little bit too. Because these are pretty efficient Bonnie upgrades. Well, or do I go for the Elite Sniper next? Elite Sniper might be a good play as well. We'll probably do Elite Sniper next will be the plan. How much are the opponent's minecarts making them, by the way? They're making 100 per minecart. We're making 300 per minecart, plus we have a sniper from our side, which is 300 more eco. However, they definitely have just a normal eco advantage to us. They have seen a lot more normal eco balloons, so that is one thing that the opponent's got going for them. But I think we're out-moneying them for sure. Let's use another crate here. And then for this next crate go-around, I would like to get an elite sniper on my end is the plan. Opponent actually sold their... Okay. They got an overdrive up. All right, they're playing it safe. Overdrive is pretty good at popping the minecarts, so they'll be good there. Everything's going fine here. That discount village. Maybe I should have gotten the discount village before I got like all the shrapnels on the snipers too. Definitely can maybe optimize the early game even a little bit more than I did this match. The early game with the strategy is really weird, but it's kind of fun learning it, you know? Learning the best way to defend everything. It's fun. Sniper is not really built for the early game. All right, let's get this up. Had to sell the village for it, but that's totally fine. Elite Sniper is now on the field, ladies and gentlemen. And we're gonna upgrade Bonnie and send Pink Balloon Eco. We're doing actually really well here now. I like this a lot. Now, as for rushing the opponent, I probably will at some point. Right now, though, they already have an overdrive. I'm probably not gonna send a Moab, but fortified ZMG, maybe a send. I do have to be aggressive, obviously, because they have the life advantage. But I don't think Taklu Village survives round 40, especially with Bonnie. Bonnie doesn't really help out at all late game. Normally with Taklu Village, you go something like Gwyndolin, which gives your attacks pierce and damage late, which is important. Upgrade Bonnie a little bit more. We're gonna do all the $2,700 upgrades on Bonnie, and then after I do all of that, I will start to save up for a Monkeyopolis Village, is my plan. That should be a pretty good plan. All right, we got a Moab incoming now. The sniper solos this though, right? I'd imagine it does. Even though it's a little bit of a shorter map. Maybe Bonnie needs to help out a little bit with the dynamite in the back of the map. But we're good. There we go. Nice. All right, we've done all the $2,700 upgrades. Let's get up a sniper on our side. Let's use that. Send out the beast here. Full auto rifle. First on this. Okay, we're good. Full auto rifle on strong. No, wait, no. First. We're good. We're fine. Opponent is getting very aggressive at us, but it's not a problem. Like, holy cow, that was a big rush. I should have just exploded minecarts, to be honest. I did not explode minecarts there, which was bad. Alright, strong on the sniper is now effective. The problem was strong on my full auto was not doing anything against the rainbows because they sent the BFB beforehand. So it was actually a pretty smart rush from the opponent. Like, I gotta give them that. That was a pretty well-constructed rush from them. The most effective way would probably have just been to get a Dark Knight on my end. That's what I would do if I was given the chance again. But either way, we're good. Let's send the opponent a fortified ZMG, by the way. Because again, I need to play a little bit aggressive, for sure. And we'll get this Opolis here soon. Let's send ourselves the beast. We got some solid damage in against it. I'm going to sell the Super Monkey here soon and get up the Monkeyopolis. Opponent's getting a bunch of attacks on their side. Do they have glue or what's their third? We still haven't seen the opponent's third, so I'm curious as to what it is. Let's also get like a couple village farms on our side. I probably should have done this earlier. Just some low tier villages. So then when I start to get sniper farms, the sniper farms are discounted. It's actually pretty important too. They end up tower boosting. They get relentless glue. Yeah, it is glue. Okay. As I expected. Holy lag. Dude, relentless glue does this to the game. I don't know why it's so laggy, but when people use relentless glue when they tower boost and all the glue puddles are being used, this is what always happens. The game lags an insane amount. Like, oh my gosh. How long is this lag gonna happen? Stop the lag, relentless glue. You're breaking my game. Oh, we're sinking. Please fix. Please fix. All right, we're back finally. I don't know if they DC'd or not, but the lag has subsided, which is fantastic. We're going to elite defender on our side just to deal with the beast here. Perfect. The lag is gone, ladies and gentlemen, and that's all that matters. Oh, they are here. I think they're ecoing right now. Wait, actually, I can't even tell if they are. Are they ecoing? I'm not even sure if they are. Oh, no, they got super glue. They're here. They got super glue. Okay. They're sending me a ZOMG. Okay. ZOMG incoming. Plan here most likely is to get up a triple discount super monkey. They're sending me the rainbows again. The rainbows this time should not be that hard to deal with. And we can get a main Moab. All right. There we go. Easy defense for this. This defends. Yep. Explode the minecarts just for good measure. All right, we're going to upgrade Bonnie a little bit now. The plan is simply I'm going to send my opponent a humongous late game rush with a ton of sniper income and a ton of Bonnie income. And that should be super effective. If the opponent rushes me a ton, I can send them rush earlier because they won't have that much money to rush me. But basically, that's what we're going to be doing here. So far, though, we are actually making a lot of money. I'm going to stop my eco. Probably at 5k will be the amount of eco I go for here. We've got a lot of sniper farms on our field. Our Bonnie's actually not upgraded a ton right now. I will upgrade Bonnie more in a bit. I just kind of want to get the sniper farms down first, though. Before I start indulging in Bonnie upgrades. We're upgrade Bonnie a little bit now. Almost at the 5,000 eco mark. If they send me around 30 fortified BAD, we get Cripple Moab and some Sun Avatars. Is the plan. They are, okay. So, can't farm anymore, obviously. But that's totally fine. Let's get camo detection on this village as well. Oh, wait, I need camo detection on another village. Perfect. This should defend. Yep, that, we actually popped that decently easily. That wasn't that bad. Alright, let's just start upgrading Bonnie now. We'll start upgrading Bonnie a ton. Get that to a pretty high level for us. One BAD is not very difficult to defend for us. We are completely fine here. And if this isn't a huge BAD rush, I actually don't even need to get Sun Temple up. Because I can defend with like Homeland Defense and just more Sun Avatars. Would be the plan. Sun Temple is probably not going to be something I buy this game. Are they sending me Purple Blue Nico? Oh, that's not smart. Maybe I rush them right now then. If they're sending purples. Yeah, they don't definitely don't have that much money. I think we rush right now then. Let's do that. There's no way they have money to defend with sending Purple Blue Nico. And all the rushes they send me on top of that. They were rushing me way too much to be able to defend the ZOMG Rush of Death here. The ZOMG Rush of Death is coming to ruin your day, brother. I just sold Bonnie. That's totally fine. I should have... I think that sells the minecarts automatically, though, if you sell Bonnie like that. Alright. Let's see if he defends, ladies and gentlemen, or if they counter rush me, which I think would probably be the more likely case. They hit me with the good game. Okay. They are not currently close at all. And it looks like the opponent ends up going... Oh, wait, what? Maybe not going down yet. Yeah, there's just too many ZOMGs for the super glue to deal with. It gets pierce capped quite easily, and they're down. All right, I'll catch you guys in the next game. That was a good first match with this loadout. Let's get it. All right, guys, our next match of today's video is on the map of Garden, and man, I do not know the placements at all for this map. I'm going to start with the sniper right here and hope this is a fine spot, but I really have no clue. So, yeah, opponent's starting with the Spike-a-Port on their end. All right, nicely done. Spike-a-Port is interesting for sure. I guess I'll keep sniper on first. Now, where do I want to have my Bonnie placed is the question of the day. And they also brought Churchill, so I'm assuming it's a Dart Churchill type of loadout is my guess. Maybe close targeting for the sniper? We're already struggling to red balloons here. This is not a good start for your boys. This is not a good start. Okay, we're fine. Yeah, I don't know where I should have placed the sniper. We'll put on close, though. And we'll get even faster firing on it. All right. They got their Churchill down. Nicely done. And I'll probably just do a similar tactic to what I did on Offtide, where I just spam these snipers alongside of this. That should work out decently for me. So we'll get another sniper on strong here. And we'll get another one right here. I'm going to put these snipers kind of on good spots for the shrapnel too, in case I want to upgrade them to shrapnel later, is my plan. And we'll start upgrading Bonnie's minecarts as well on top of that. Why the heck not? And we'll get the farmer and the balloon bot down as well. Okay, fine start. Could have been better, could have been worse. Not awful. We'll take it, we'll take it. And I'll get one more sniper right here. All right, we're vibing. Full mode jacket. Explode the minecarts. Perfect. Opponent is balloon boosting me pink balloons. We got all of our snipers on strong. I think I need a fourth sniper though, if I remember correctly. Four of these is the way. Not three. Four full metal jackets on strong. There we go. That should work out decently. Yeah, this shrapnel sniper in the back is just not very effective, is kind of what I'm noticing. Maybe put this one in close with shrapnel as well. Oh, this is really bad, actually. This is looking really bad right now. Another one close. Oh man, we're fighting from behind. I don't know if this is the map for Sniper Village Super, or at least I don't know if my placements are bad or something. This is not looking good at the moment. I think we can fight from this though. Even though it looks really bad right now, I feel like we can make something of this game. I just need to lock in, basically. I just need to lock in. If I can get through the early game, this strategy is unbelievable in the later game, as we know. So I just need to get through the early game here. With my head above water, is all it comes down to. All right, we're alive, we're alive. Do I upgrade the minecarts again, or is that too crazy? Maybe get shrapnel on this one as well. Shrapnel on everything. I have the minecart explosion available for yellow balloons, which is nice. So we'll explode the minecarts here in a second. Let's do it now. Perfect. We're fine. Upgrade the minecarts again. We're at 180 per minecart. Very good. Maybe first targeting is better than close, because close targeting on this guy keeps hitting the AI path, which is bad for me. If I have it on first, it targets... That actually might have been what I needed. I'm just used to putting the shrapnels on close, obviously, but first might actually be better in this case because of how the paths line up, if that makes sense. Interesting. I'm pretty sure that's what I should have been doing. Okay, we're gonna get our discount village right here. Monkey Commerce. They are going sniper. I'm assuming John's third tower is ninja. Dart Sniper Ninja is a pretty popular load on this map, and it's pretty strong as well. They're giving me the hearts. I'll give them the hearts as well. We're vibing. And we'll upgrade this to Bouncing Bullet next is gonna be the plan. Most likely going to have to explode minecarts this round. Actually, how's our snipers doing? Our snipers actually appear to be doing pretty good in Zebras. Maybe I don't need to explode minecarts. We are vibing right now. Okay, nice. I think we're in a fine position. All things considered. For how wacky that early game was kind of feeling for us. We're doing good. Round 10. They got the Juggernaut up on their end. Nicely done. I'm going to sell this top sniper. And I'm going to get my own bouncing bullet up. Perfect. Unfortunately, this sniper is not in the range of my village, so if I need to upgrade semi-automatic, it won't be discounted. But that's totally fine. Monkey economy. Nice. And the plan is simply to get that supply drop up super early. Opponent got their bouncing bullet up. Fair enough. Now, if they rush me, obviously, that's going to throw a wrench in our plan. We'll have to buy some defense and react accordingly. So we will see about that. So far, nothing. And we got our supply drop up, which is fantastic. Are they going to let me greed? Or are they going to punish me? No, still nothing. Okay. I'll get a shrapnel here to kind of help out a little bit. And we'll collect the crate. They got their own supply drop up. So if it is Dart, Sniper, Ninja, as I'm expecting, I'm not really too worried that they have life advantage. That strategy is good late, but it's not going to survive round 40 in the slightest. Especially... when we're gonna have so much money in the late game. See, I'm not really too worried about the life advantage here. Even if it's Dart's Super Monkey Sniper, that probably would be difficult to beat late, but I still feel like we could beat it late because they don't have Village, which Village does make a big difference. Village makes a humongous difference. Okay, we're good here. Balloons actually started to become a little bit of an issue. It's funny, I feel like we would defend Region Rainbows decently with the shrapnel. But pink balloons can actually be more difficult sometimes just because it's more separate balloons, if that makes sense. So we'll buy a semi-automatic on our sniper just to play it safe. We're doing good here. I won't get the elite sniper on this crate. I'll get it on the next crate is my plan. This is actually a pretty good sniper spot, by the way, the supply drop. It doesn't get blocked at all from the obstacle if you look at it for the scent path. It sees the balloons right here and sees the balloons back here, which is exactly what we're looking for. Should I send them a fortified MOAB on the next round? I'm considering it. They don't have elite sniper, so maybe fortified MOAB is a good send. I'm not sure how much money John has on hand, though. I think I'll send it. Why the heck not? On round 18, we'll send one and see what we get, see what we force out of it. Maybe a crossbow or maybe a sharpshooter, maybe something else. They remove the obstacle. They get a sharpshooter up. They're going to need a tower boost with this. They go for a second jug. Actually, maybe don't need tower boost with the second jug. No. Oh, I almost got the life advantage off that. If I got the life advantage off that, that actually would have been fantastic. Man. I didn't want them to die there, obviously. But I also wanted to get the life advantage, so I guess that's a lot to ask. Alright, they rushed me. I end up getting up a super monkey and tower boosting. We're good. If they re-rush me, I simply get a robo monkey, and that defends re-rushes pretty well. So we'll see if they end up doing that. I can sell all for Bonnie without it being that bad as well, because I haven't put that much money into Bonnie upgrades yet. It doesn't look like they're re-rushing me though, so we're gonna actually upgrade Bonnie a ton then. Opponents getting an elite sniper on their own end, my guess is. There it is. Let's actually send a fortified BFB their way. Let's keep the pressure up a little bit. Just a fortified BFB, nothing crazy. But we do force a sticky bomb out of it initially, which is really good, so I'll take that. It is ninja, by the way, as I was expecting it to be. Oh, I need to send out the beast here. Okay, one sec. I always forget about this beast, bro. They should be good against this. They got a shinobi stack for the ninja as well. All right, beast now. The good thing is the AI path is actually pretty long on this map, so it gives us a good amount of time to damage the beast before it goes out. Much longer than the scent path, obviously. All right, all of these snipers in the range of the village. Oh, I should go for an increased eco village. I completely forgot about that, to be honest. I don't know why I forgot about that, but that is pretty important to have on my end. So we will start saving up for the increased eco village now is going to be the plan. If they send tight leads, I should be decently fine with my setup too. We have enough sniper farms to defend tight leads well. Plus the full auto rifle helps out a decent bit. It one-shots them. ZOMG, is it fortified or non-fortified? It is non-fortified, okay. What's the best way to deal with this? Best way to deal with this is getting a Monkeyopolis on our side. And probably a main MOAB. And we'll get Jungle Drums on this. This should defend. We've got enough snipers to clean up the insides, right? They explode the minecarts. We're good. The explosions of the minecarts actually helped out a decent bit there too. That was a good way to defend a ZOMG, I think. We held our breath on it. We didn't tower boost. And now we can sell the main MOAB as well. Very good. Do I send them a set of tight MOABs? I think I should. We'll see what they do here. Oh my gosh! They still might die to the ceramics. That forced them to sell every sniper farm? Oh, the value I just got in one set of tight MOABs. Dude, guys, that was a $4,000 rush that I just sent. And you see the reaction I got from the opponent? That was definitely not the best way for them to defend that by any means, but dang, I got good, great value with that rush. If I were them with the loadout, I probably would have insta-saboed the MOABs and then gotten up a sticky bomb with a bunch of shinobi stacks. It's probably the best way to defend that. And that could defend. Maybe tower boost too. You could tower boost as well. But selling every sniper farm for a master bomber against one set of MOABs is not the way, brother. Now I have a massive, massive money advantage. Might as well start getting sniper farms up at the top. Just a couple. Almost at 5,000 eco too. Our eco is really good here. I think I'll stop my eco. We'll stop my eco and hit round 29 would be the plan. Round 29 and I'll stop my eco. I think that's a fine plan. Do I send them a round 30 fortified? I just tower boosted by accident. Oh well. It is. Since I'm tower boosted, I might as well send a beast out too. Maybe pop the beast through the tower boost. Or, yeah, we popped it. Okay, nice. At least we made some use of it. Fat fingering the tower boost. We'll upgrade Bonnie a bunch. We got 3,000 Bonnie eco now. Where do I want to put my temple? I kind of want to get a temple up now. Okay, that's enough magic. That's enough support. We need a sniper in here for military. Or two snipers, probably. All right, there we go. We got all the sacrifices in line for the temple. Are they going to send? Are they going to send the fortified BD? I'm actually going to send one. I'll send one. We've been applying some pressure this game. Why not continue with just one fortified BD? Maybe they'll overreact like they did earlier. Yeah, we forced like three sniper farm cells with that. That's great. I'll take it. They're sending one of their own. Okay, I'm going to have to sell a bunch against this because I'm going to go for the temple route. That's totally fine, though. Opponent's about to die to DTs.
There's no way you die to DTs there, bro. Sabo, the DDTs get more shinobi stacks. Come on.
Well, either way, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video with the current meta strategy in Bloons Sea Boss 2, in my opinion. I mean, Sniper, Village, Super Monkey is like unbeatable right now, guys. It's so strong. So give it a try. That's it for today. I'm like out. Peace, guys. Have a good one. And I honestly think I'm just going to get that Sun Temple up because I want to be careful defensively. So buying that early is not a... They're dead. They're dead. Main Moab. Oh my gosh. And you pirate emote on me, bro. What does that emote even mean? How does that happen, brother?